Well, opening the domes, what could go wrong? Do you really want to know the answer to that question? What could go wrong? Because Hemamont did not hold back on what can go wrong.
Tickets for PDXCon 2019 are now available. Tickets are limited and we've already sold out of the Emperor tier, so act fast. If you've purchased your tickets before the end of May, you enjoy a 20% discount.
Welcome everyone. It is launch day for Green Planet. I know we got a lot of people hyped. I'm Jonathan, our community developer, and I got Adam here today.
Yeah. I'm Adam. I'm the creative producer for Surviving Mars.
So this is the guy who's been making all of the incredible trailers and putting together videos for us and basically all of the art assets that he's made as well, including this beautiful red / kind of greenish blue planet now. This is actually in-game footage of the planetary view, right?
Yes.
We are here today to, one, count down to Green Planet, which is launching in 46 minutes.
Yep.
But until then, I've got some nice gameplay that we can show off, too. This is a colony that I've been building on my own. So I am here at Sol 98, and you can tell that this is taking a long time to get terraformed. I'm doing pretty good as far as progression. I've made it above the required atmosphere needed for surviving outside of a dome, but temperature isn't quite there yet. Water, I've started getting out, but this one takes a long time. And vegetation, I'm still pretty low at, but at least around my colony.
And you have colonists here?
I did bring colonists. Let's see, actually. Let's go to some of my forestation plants. I have spaced them out pretty well. All of these hexagons here are forestation plants. And I just started trying to plant bushes. So as we start up, I am trying to get it to not be dependent on seeds, because seeds I've had to ship in a lot of. But as soon as I switch over to bushes, let's keep on here.
Oh, then the drones collect the seeds from the bushes.
So it requires 0.2 seeds, but they're growing 0.5 seeds, although it takes a couple souls to get going. Mm. So if I can get bushes growing, and I can only do it in places that have good enough soil quality, then that means I can stop importing seeds. You want to tell everyone a little bit about the free update, too?
Yeah, so part of the free update is both the kind of flattening the landscaping so we can build ramps.
I can show off that really quick. I've already done it here. I built a ramp in this area.
Yeah.
You have to start on some flat terrain, and if I need to get way up here, let's see if we can do this. All the way up to here. And I can see on the right it's going to require a lot of waste rock. Thankfully, I have a ton of waste rock. Let's do it. This is another part of the free update is I can just click and drag and select these drones. Yeah, I just realized that I'm going to have to work on figuring out how to get waste rock over here. Maybe I can level something as well. So if I decide to flatten, for example, this beautiful area, I'm just going to hold down shift key, click, 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 and how much? Okay, that's enough excess waste rock. So they'll go and dump it here and then start building this gigantic, glorious ramp up to here. So the atmosphere is going up from our carbonate processors. That's these guys over here. They're converting waste rock into CO2. I had to build three of them, which was super expensive to do.
Oh, yeah. But they are big as well.
Yeah. They're nice. And I had tons of waste rock around here as well that I was trying to collect. Thankfully, this one expired, but I actually had three concrete extractors getting enough waste rock for these two to run. And then I built two magnetic field generators. These don't increase your atmosphere, but they do will change the loss of atmosphere parameter. So that's that second line there. Mm-hmm. That's helping me keep in the atmosphere. Otherwise, it will continually decrease. But you can still see there's a lot of red Mars over here.
Mm.
And this will continually progress as I get more of those parameters up. That's always a nice way to see how you're doing. So these ones are part of Green Planet, the green ones, and the blue ones are free. So you can capture meteors, which will bring down rare metals and anomalies and stuff like that. But we have the launch magnetic shield destroys a rocket, launches space mirror.
That's this a lot of heat. You
heats
gain.
Up a lot of temperature. I could probably do this one, capture some ice asteroids. Those are the only ones I've unlocked. There's a few more as well, but I think we'll be all right if we can just. I only need a little more temperature, yeah. And then my atmosphere should get up to 100% pretty soon. Yeah, I need to get that up to 100%, and we'll get there. And this one needs to get up to, I believe, is it 70 or 80%?
For what?
So people won't die when I open the domes.
I can't remember. Actually.
We'll find out soon enough. I'm pretty sure it's in that area, maybe 75%. I can go ahead and get up this breakthrough tech where lakes will be self-sufficient. So that means I don't have to keep pumping water. Let's go ahead and build some more lakes so I can get more water. So I can build four different sizes. I bet I could fit a huge one in here somewhere.
You want to build them close to where you have vegetation, right?
Well, not necessarily where I have vegetation, but where I want vegetation. Because you want to improve the soil quality. You can see here that we're going to get nice soil quality around water. And that means we're going to be able to grow eventually bushes and trees, which do require some good amounts. Can you show us some dogs, please? Let's show off some pets. Let's see if we can find a dog.
We have a horse.
I've got lots of pets because I got... I'll show you why I got so many pets. So I have two vistas here, and then I
comfort
put a
boost.
Lot of colonists in here. So we've got our pet horse, our pet deer, and our pet penguin waddling around.
Yeah.
If you've ever been to, like, I was in Japan
the
2 months
llama,
ago.
My favorite.
The llamas. I was in Japan 2 months ago, and there's a few different places where there's deer that are just completely tame, and they just walking all around. Let's show off these buildings really quick before we do the lake. There's lakes here, various lake sizes. Forestation plants use seeds to grow lichen, grass, bushes, trees, then mixed trees. Open farms. These are really cool, actually. I should have built one of these. And that will affect the crops we can grow, or we can have cropped failures if it's not good enough. We'll build this gigantic open farm here. And then after that, we have the GHG factories. These are one of the first buildings. These and forestation plants are some of the first ones. This starts increasing your temperature. I built my first two over here. And then later, I was able to build this, basically a wonder, but this is a core heat convector. And this not only protects this area from cold waves, but that increases that temperature by a decent amount as well. After that, we have, not planetary view. We want carbonate processors. I showed those off. They convert your waste rock into CO2. Core heat convectors. I built these over here. These are basically Mars quake generators. That's really all they do. Do not build these next to your domes or you're just going to break everything. But why is everyone starving? Because I swear I have tons of food stockpiled. This is a food... Yeah, I've got food,
there's
people.
The food.
What is wrong with you guys? Where's the break in my supply chain? It's all in here. This was really bad planning to build a gigantic, massive... ramp
maybe
up to
that's
nothing.
Why you needed dozers
but
so
I,
they could carry
you're right.
take care of it instead
Can
of all
I,
the drones.
I might be able to do a supply drop with a nope. I can't get a dozer. Well, opening the domes, what could go wrong? Do you really want to know the answer to that question? What could go wrong? Because Hemamont did not hold back on what can go wrong. If you open the domes and then you don't sustain your atmosphere, everyone's going to die. I mean, that's kind of a given, but they won't be able to breathe. They can freeze to death. And then, obviously, you have to still keep their comfort and, all the other disasters and stuff that can still happen, but it's those two, freezing to death or suffocating. Can you reestablish domes? Okay, so you can't close up the domes again, correct? No, you can't.
No.
You can't. It's a decision you have to take, and you can't... change that. However, you actually will still build the dome foundations because that's still where you'll build all of the buildings. So the self-sufficient dome is this one here. But it basically comes with oxygen and a moisture evaporator and a tank for both of those. So yeah. It's kind of an easy mode dome, but because I picked the easiest sponsor for this, they came with a prefab for that.
Yeah.
So just making things a little easier when you're trying to
just can be a good start, I think.
Yeah. For beginner players, it makes it really nice to have that. Oh, come on. Shoot, I forgot they do this. Alrighty, guys, you ready?
Ready
to
for
watch
a bombardment?
Please don't. Come on. Don't destroy my colony. I need.
Oh, shoot, it's leaking.
It's a leak. Fix it. I'm in trouble, guys. We need to show off open domes by the end of.
Well, if they bombard it, maybe it will become open.
We're getting destroyed. This was terrible planning on my part. I was trying to show you guys how fun it was on Mars when you can open the domes and Earth is attacking us.
Yeah.
Cursed Earthians. No, they killed my drones. We're never going to finish this ramp. All right, let's start salvaging drones. Shoot. I guess let's use our handy dandy click and drag function and let's reassign some drones.
There were a lot of drones there.
Reassign here. There we go. See how easy that was?
That was very good choice, I think.
Yeah, because I lost all my drones. Thanks for bombarding us, Earth. They hate us. Where's our trees? Can I build trees yet, though? Yeah, I could. I can start planting trees now.
Oh.
We did it just in time, even with all of the destruction.
Look at those beautiful fireworks. Was that not perfect timing? Perfect timing.
Fantastic.
I'm excited now. So this is what happens. Let's get rid of all this other junk about my terribly destroyed colony.
Where's the rest of the peoples? Isn't there usually a bigger group?
Yeah.
Well, this is all that matters.
Yes.
We're the only ones that matter. So this is what happens, guys. You have this button here that says planet habitable. Your attention is required, and you get this beautiful message here. Won't read the whole thing, but you guys know what's going to happen here. So we can open the dome or leave them closed for now.
Pop the confetti first.
Pop the confetti.
They want us to pop the confetti now.
Yeah.
I see what they're saying.
So confetti in the
trailer, take a hold.
Not to my
trailer. Not at me.
Everyone can go and play.
1, 2, 3.
Okay.
No?
1, 2, 3.
Yeah.
Up in the roof. Up in the roof.
Up high.
Up in the roof.
But where?
Which
this is scary.
Don't do it, Dwight. Not do it. I want to do it.
We're having technical difficulties.
No, I don't.
We're going to show them opening the domes. Let's do this. Here we go, everybody. There we go.
Could you not build the biggest
open domes? Though? The capital city? You can only build it once you actually open domes. So now I can go over to this wonder here. And oops, it's in... where is it? Here we are.
Terrible.
Capital city. And this one is nice because you can actually build it in...
It's huge.
Yeah.
So if you do this, right? If you don't clean all of the stuff up, this would be only a tiny city.
Yeah. You only need to have one of the water sections connect on flat terrain and the very center on flat terrain. So we'll leave that up to you guys to populate the capital city and explore all of your animals going out into the wild. Look at these guys.
That must be a really good day.
This is a great
that's a nice.
You know,
day
you guys weren't here early in the stream, but this is right after Earth just bombarded our colony.
Yeah, that's less of a
so
good day.
Jealous.
I don't even know what would have happened if I'd opened the colony before.
The bombs dropped.
Oh, that could have been really bad.
Yeah.
Okay, we'll leave that up to you guys to explore. We're going to end this stream for now, and I'll actually be rolling over into City Skylines. But again, from the whole team, let's give them thanks again.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you, guys. Thank you.